Good morning, students. Today we will be starting with history part, the first chapter, Medieval India. So in this chapter, first of all, I will tell you what we all have to study. Medieval India, first, what is Medieval India? From where it starts, how many different parts of there in history? Then, what is India? How many different names does India have? What is the importance of Medieval India in our Indian history? And what are the different sources, either that can be archaeological, like means monuments, and there can be literature like books, Upanishads, which help us to know, you can say, the resources from which we can know about the Medieval India. So just first, what is Medieval India? So Medieval India, simply, Medieval generally stands for something that is located in the middle. So Medieval is in between. You know that history, Indian history, is divided into three parts: ancient India, Medieval India, and modern India. So Indian history is divided into three parts: ancient India, Medieval India, and modern India. So Medieval is in between the ancient and the modern India. And when we are talking about the centuries or the year from which the Medieval India starts, so then you can say that the Medieval India starts from 700 CE, that is also known as Christ era. And so that can also, you can call it as AD. So 700 AD, it starts from 700 AD and it goes till 1750 CE, means 1750 AD. So today we are living in 2020 AD, so you can obviously can understand that the we are talking about 300, 400, 5 years back, that history which starts from 700 CE and goes up to 1750 CE is the timeline or the chronology in which the Medieval, we call the history as Medieval India. Then for further, you can say for further clarification, you can say that the Medieval period is also divided into two parts. Medieval India is divided into two parts. First is called Early Medieval period and the second is called Late Medieval period. So the first period, that is the Early Medieval period, starts from 700 CE and it goes up to 1200 CE. So CE or AD is the same thing. CE, that is Christ era, or AD, I don't know, Domini, is the same thing. And 700 to 1200 CE is the timeline of Early Medieval period. After that comes the Late Medieval period, that starts from 1200 CE to 1750 CE. So the Medieval India is divided into two parts: Early Medieval period and the later Late Medieval periods, that is divided by 1750 CE. So starting from 700 to 1200, it is Early Medieval period. From 1200 to 1750, it is Late Medieval period. Next topic is India and its different name. So we all know that during ancient times, during medieval times, and in modern times, the name of our country keeps on changing. So during ancient time, we called India, there were some different names. So one of the name is Jamudvip and the other is Bharatvarsha. As Bharatvarsha, because the country was ruled by a tribe called Bharata. And so as the Indian Persian invaded India, so they founded that India was a country of Sapt Sindhu means that the seven rivers flow all the Indus tributaries that flows, so they also termed it as Sapt Sindhu. Then coming with the medieval India, when the Muslim dynasty started play in Delhi, so they started the calling India as Hindustan, and from there the British came in modern India and they start calling it as India. So you can see that there is a name change, start from Bharat Varsha, then Hindustan, and later it was known as India. So in ancient time it started with Bharat Varsha, in medieval it comes to Hindustan, then in modern India. So when it comes to the importance of medieval history, why we study medieval history, or what are the importance, what brings by the medieval history? So starting at the end of the ancient history, the situations was not good in India. There was no political stability. The rulers, small provinces, fighting for their own good, for wealth, and to keep their head high. So during the medieval time, the Muslim dynasty, there was a rise in Muslim dynasty as there was a vacuum. So from the West Asias, the Central Asias, and from all the areas of Persias, the Muslim dynasty started attracting by the Indian wealth, and they started the invasion, and that led to the rise in Muslim dynasty. One of the importance of the medieval history in that one rise of Muslim dynasties, and that Muslim dynasty also provided the political stability for many centuries. So that means rise in Muslim dynasties, then the political stability, and as there was a political stability, when there will be a political stability in any country, that will help the country to grow, that will help in the development, and that what happened during the medieval period, the trade flourished. So there was a lot of trade and commerce going on from India to different parts of the world, and overseas trades flourished. We have a great importance of trade at that times. We traveled, we have the trade relations with Iran, that time known as Persia, all the European countries and all the West Asian countries. So trade flourished. And the fourth point, which you can say, is the spread of Islam. So Bhakti movement and the Sufi movement also important highlight of this medieval periods. But as spread of Islam, that doesn't mean that it affected the other religions, means that the spread movements that started with the movement of love and universal brotherhood. So this is all four points. There is one more point, that is art and architecture shows a trend that never before. So that means that art and architecture also introduced by the Mughals, as they are not from this Indian, so they bring some different art and architecture from them when they come to the central, they come from the Central Asia to the Indias. They brought their painters, they brought their sculptures, they brought the artists, so they brought their architectures, everything to the Indias, and that results to the amalgamations of all the Indian culture, Hindustani cultures, and the Muslim cultures. So that also results in the developments of art and architectures. We have seen that many beautiful monuments like Lal Kela, Taj Mahal, all these are built during the medieval period. So the five points which the importance of the medieval history is that the rise of Muslim dynasties, second, the political stability that results to the third, overseas trade flourishes, and four, spread of Islam as Islam came with the Muslim dynasties, then fifth, There was a great development of art and architectures during this medieval period.